Okay, and what do we got here?
This one here is the working horse car, and with a, all with the stalls. Here again, these stalls are all loosened up, and the horses, they come out, and they bring them back in. But by keeping them tight in the stalls, they wouldn't fall over or break legs and all that sort of stuff while they're transporting them. A unique item, too, they had a trough here that was a feed trough. So at night, after they had them all in, they had ropes that would lift the tops of that, and they'd feed them while they were en route. So they'd be all ready to go again the next morning.
Mm. And they could keep them in there. Wow. Okay, and it's Ned, right?
It's Ned.
Okay, Ned. Hang on, I'm gonna pop my headphones on here. We were just talking. Great, incredible stuff. How did you get involved with this? You were telling me a little bit, but I'm here to tell me this story. You've been involved with the circus for many years. Tell me about it.
My involvement really started after I got introduced at the Circus World Museum in Baraboo and met a fellow by the name of Bob Parkinson. And he sort of put the bug in my ear about, or ignited the bug in my ear about the circus, and that's when it really started. At the same time, or soon after that, the director of the museum, Chappie Fox, asked if I'd like to start scraping some wagons, that the actual wagons. So one thing led to another, and working on the actual wagons, it started, well, you know, I started building my own. And it was just basically a wagon collection. And then we got involved with the circus model builders. And most of those people at that time were showing tents. And I said, well, I really don't want to show a tent. I was just getting started in being involved with the parade in Milwaukee. And I said, oh, I'm going to put together a parade. So I put together a 10-block parade over the years and do take it out to shows, and have had it out for the last 20 years here in the Twin City area. After I got that done, I started working on some trains again, and you just keep adding to it. You see, I work a lot with pitchers. When I did my parade, I first started with just the wagons with the horses and that, and it didn't do me right. Then I took and put a few buildings with it, and that helped look better. So it still was lacking something. I put a backdrop on it, and that made it better. And then I needed people. When you had a parade, you had to have people. So I added the people and finally got satisfied with the display and have lots of good comments about it.
You've got circus in your blood.
Well, yeah, it has been.
Since you were a kid, though, or what? I mean,
As a kid, well, we actually were forbidden to go to the circus lot, even though it was a lot, because you never knew what the family said. Well, you never know what kind of people you're going to run into. But we do remember seeing Cecil B. DeMille do some filming of the movie Greatest Show on Earth. They were doing out shots. So that has always stuck in my mind. And then they used to water the elephants at a fire hydrant just about in front of our house. So that has always stuck in my mind also. So from there, it's meeting other people, and that it's just mushroomed into a great hobby.
You would look out your door, and you'd see elephants in Wisconsin.
Yeah, on that particular summer morning, we was, yes.
I thought you would have to have that in your mind the rest of your life. I mean, how neat is that for a kid to see that? what are we going to see here in this October show? Then you're rolling out more. I mean, tell me a little bit about what this show.
The October show here at Bandana, we're in hopes to have over 15 exhibitors from at least 9 states and possibly Canada, with circus model displays and railroad. So it's what we call a gathering, a Lot 5 gathering. A gathering is like a convention or a small convention that we get together and compare notes and just a little camaraderie to get together and have a time to show what we've done over the years.